Hi, and welcome to another episode of Mr. Puzzle. Today we will talk about this puzzle here, which is called Schloss 250, in German or in English, Lock 250. It is a combination lock that was created by Jean-Claude Constantin, and the target of this lock is to open it up. But to do this, there are minimum 250 steps required to solve it. It sounds nearly impossible, but there is some mechanism inside, and as soon as you understand how it works, it's just a matter of time how you open it. However, there is also another lock available from Jean-Claude Constantin that is called the Generation Lock, and this has many more of these layers here, and also many more steps to solve it, and I think this one will keep you busy for days until you open it. This one has 250 steps, and the difficulty of this one is not too high. I would give it a 3 because it can be a little bit confusing, but usually it's not too difficult to solve. After the spoiler break, I show you how to solve it. Okay, at first let's have a closer look onto the mechanism. If I move this pin here, you can see that in the inside of the lock they're moving some pins up and down, and this enables or releases, for example, if I move this pin over here, it releases this pin and this can move one step. If I move it back, it can move one more step, and this is actually the idea that's behind, because when I move this pin here all the way over here, I release this pin and can move it one step, and then it goes step by step until the lock is open. And that is, of course, also what requires that much amount of time. I will do it now in a time lapse, and just if I have something to explain, go back into normal speed. And now I'm able to move the first step here with this pin up here. Now I proceed to move this one back over here to make the next step with this one. And I choose the camera perspective like this today because if I do it in this condition, it gets usually stuck. So therefore I'm doing it in the upright position. So now I moved it all the way over here, but as you can see, the upper one is still blocked. To release it, I need to move the pins one more time to the other side, the lower two pins, like this. I just do it right now. And if I'm over here, I might be able to move it. And now it was the first time I was able to move this one. So you can imagine how much time it takes to open it. And you can also imagine how much time it takes to open this generation lock with about 10 layers and, I don't know, minimum 10 steps each layer. Now I'm able to move the third step with the upper one, and I need to get all of them over here to open it. Oh, I think I moved in the wrong direction here. Therefore, I need to get this one back over here. So just one step further. And now only one step is missing. And it seems we are nearly done. I only need to move, I think, this one one more time. One more time over here to the left, and then I should be able to make the final move here on the top. Yep, and now I need to go back with these two also, and now I'm able to open it up. So each one of these pins locks one layer here, and it's very difficult to see, but I just turn it around. You see these chamfered slides here, and if I, for example, move this one from left to right, I push this chamfered sheet wood piece of wood here down, and this moves these sliders up and down. A very nice idea from my point of view. Not too difficult, but very confusing. As you saw, I also did the mistake that I moved in the wrong direction when I solved the puzzle, and therefore I had to do some of the moves twice. Anyway, I solved it. It's an interesting puzzle from my point of view. I will put a link in the description where you can buy it. If you're interested to see more, join my Facebook channel and my YouTube channel. And until next time, keep on puzzling!